Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's ask the question, are too many developers claiming to be AI specialists? All right, so once again, it has been a while since I've done a proper video, aside from the live streams. I've just been really busy lately. I mean, last few weeks, all we've really done are the live streams, but I'm gonna get more regular at it as soon as I clear my schedule a little bit more. But I had a really good comment that came in last week on a video from Carlos Silva. Now the video was on, Are All Developers Terrible? Right, which was, and Carlos posted this really good question, which I wanted to share with you guys so that I'll give my opinion on it, but I want to get your guys' opinion on it too. So let us know what you think regarding this question by Carlos. So here it is. Carlos says, "Hi Eric, I have a question related to this topic. How do you rate the software market today? This is a high-level generic question, but there's two specific problems that I'm finding. The first point is the hype around AI and machine learning that I see as a problem for the industry. And there's a lot to be said regarding the hype. Most engineers add AI and ML to their CV just to get jobs, even if they have no background on these jobs. Job offers also ask for AI and ML because everyone else is doing it. So we end up with work that is not well defined and people that don't know how to do the work. Companies want AI/ML, but people are just looking at YouTube videos that teach how to classify dogs and cats." Another point of discussion is around degrees versus online courses versus self-taught. How can we fairly compare and rate CVs? Carlos is a really good point, a really good question, and it's funny what you say about AI and machine learning, because it sounds a little bit to me like I can remember when Agile was kind of new, or you know, everyone all of a sudden overnight became an Agile developer. And I was talking to this one developer who was he was the head of IT at this one company that I was consulting for, and I went in there and he was talking about how their organization was an Agile organization, right? They were Agile. He said, "We practice Agile and extreme programming." But they didn't. Like, it was kind of a thing where he actually thought he was Agile, but they didn't follow any Agile principles. He just thought it sounded like something they would do. He just, you know, it was one of those things where he kind of thought, yeah, that's about pretty much this. He didn't do any research into it, but it kind of covered his thing. And at the time, a lot of people were saying that, but when you actually talk to the real hardcore Agile people who were doing, you know, they were doing practicing Scrum and doing their burn down charts, or they were doing whatever pair programming, doing extreme programming, you know, doing all the different types of stuff and having unit tests and all kinds of stuff. There are people who really, really did it, and there's other people who kind of thought they did it, so they put it on their CV, right? It kind of reminds me a little bit of that, right? When I talk about machine learning and AI, right? There's like, I tried to learn a little bit of machine learning a few years ago, and the learning curve, it like goes like this, and it goes straight up, right? It gets really hard, really fast. It was way over my head, right? And I could see there's probably a lot of people out there who think, yeah, because they watched a few Siraj videos, whatever, before we found out he was a fraud or whatever. They found a few, you know, classification dogs and cats, and then they think they know it, but they have no idea. And hopefully they'll be weeded out in their interview process. But at the same time, like you said, there's a lot of employers who think they need that kind of stuff, but they don't. They think they just maybe just need really good algorithms or somebody who could think critically about stuff, but they think, no, machine learning is probably something we should need, right? It's really weird. I have two thoughts on this, because it's like, I think there's a lot of people who think they know something and they put it on their CV before they're even competent with it, right? I've hired people like this. It's really difficult when you hire somebody and they've never actually done something to completion. Like they say, I know Android, but they've never actually released an app, or they never built an app end to end, right? Maybe they did a Hello World thing, but or whatever, and they're still like, I'm an Android developer. But they have really no experience on it, right? And you also have other people who they won't put, like on the other side of the spectrum, who will not put something on their CV because they don't feel like they're the experts at it, right? So, and it's one of those things where for anybody who's learned software, you know that there's a range. There's from beginner to like, you know, badass. From beginner to badass, And all of us kind of are in somewhere in between. Some of us are more towards a beginner, some are more towards a badass, but like it's still worth putting on your CV a lot of the times, right? Because it's not a Boolean, it's a range, right? So sometimes it is worth kind of putting that stuff on your CV. But what I would do, and what I have always done, is when I put skills on my CV, I have the skills and then the number of years I've been using it, right? So like if I, like, my CV has always had, you know, I've got whatever, 8 years experience with C#, whatever. So that way, when I go through and have those kind of interviews, I know that this is the kind of stuff that I've worked on. CVs are weird because they're not, a lot of people consider CVs like this is a form that I'm filling in, like an employment form, but it isn't. It's a bit of marketing material. So it's kind of like you want, basically the CV has one job only. The CV will not get you the job. The CV gets you the interview. So that degree, for me, I don't think the degree's ever really helped me very much. I have a degree in history at Central Missouri State University, which is not a prestigious school, and it has nothing to do with the job I'm going for. But and I don't think it's ever really gotten me the interview. I think for me, it's always been the experience and the portfolio and the rest of everything on it that gets me in the door. And then from then on, it is that confidence that you can demonstrate, right? When you go in there, you know, and they're looking at people, they're gonna look at somebody who thinks that they're gonna be very rigid, and they're gonna ask a few questions and the person's gonna fall apart, especially if it's something they don't know, like machine learning. Or it's gonna be somebody who's confident, and they're like, even if you go in there and say, I have exposure to machine learning, or I have exposure to Agile, or I've done a little bit of this. I'm very open and honest about what I know and what I don't know when I go in for a CV. When I go in for an interview, and a lot of times they really appreciate it. It's the, you know, it's coming across as you can handle this kind of stuff and everything. So when it comes to like the CV versus online versus self-taught, you know, I don't think it's much, once you get a bit of experience under your belt, then it doesn't matter as much. But when you're at the beginning stages, then yeah, well, but usually, you know, if you can get to that interview stage, especially if they have a technical person in there interviewing you also, that's when they find out, that's when they're able to separate the posers from the actual developers. And if they don't find it out then there's usually a probation period, which they'll get rid of you if you don't know it anyway. But it's an interesting point you bring up, Carlos, because I'm sure it's much, I mean, like, yeah, everybody thinks they need machine learning, but I'm sure most of them don't. But I still think it's worth putting your CV through. Even if you don't have machine learning on your CV, send it through. You know, like, always be sending it through, right? Because you never know who else is applying for these jobs. That's just my thoughts on it. What do you guys think? What do you guys honestly think about it? Do you think that that machine learning is overrated for most of the software that people need out there? Do you think it's worth learning? Because when I think about it, there's a few use cases where I think it would be really useful. But there's a lot where I think it would be overkill. So anyway, just my thoughts on that today. Thanks very much for the question, Carlos. Everybody, if you have not liked and subscribed and all that kind of stuff, please do it. And join our Discord server if you want to join a lot of discussions that people are having on there. And that is it for today. I'll talk to you again next time.